They're meant to prevent contraband from entering our jails, but one prison employee has come clean on being in on the act. Accused of smuggling tobacco and steroids into Windsor Jail, the 37-year-old man has told Nine News why a number of people working for corrective services keep doing it.
Hours after being caught in the act, Alex Bisopoulos comes clean.
It's not hard at all. It's not hard at all. People get caught every day. Officers get caught every day.
Police arresting the prison truck driver inside a Windsor jail yesterday for allegedly making illegal deliveries.
So why did you do it?
For extra money, I said. For extra money. They cut hours down at work. They keep cutting down hours, keep down in hours. And then you weren't making men's meat. So you just did it what you had to do to survive.
He's accused of smuggling tobacco and steroids and getting cash from inmates' families in return. And he says it's not hard.
Just talk to them. They're like work release within the facilities. So you mingle with a lot of inmates. You can mingle with drug dealers, you can mingle with top-end murderers, you can mingle with drink drivers. So you mingle with everybody.
There are crack teams dedicated to targeting contraband in our jails. But it's hard when corrective service officers are smuggling illegal goods themselves. At least three have been charged this year.
How officers sleeping with inmates, getting pregnant, got caught with phones, got caught with drugs. Did you see the one with silver water? Got caught with all these phones and drugs. How is that going to stop? You can't stop.
Yet a special task force with police and corrective services based here at Long Bay is making inroads.
It's just that if you know the loopholes, that's all. The security that they use for the jails is no good at all.
Emma Partridge, Nine News.